concerning the humor.
It's ridiculous, I think.
Why?
Because I believe that the Americans are behind the protests. Like, they're funding the protests here, so I think he's created the problem.
How long have you lived in Hong Kong?
28 years.
28 years, and you live here with your family?
Yes.
And do you work in the financial business sector?
Yes.
Will your business be affected by this?
Everybody's business is affected by it.
What kind of effects are you expecting?
I think that it's affecting Hong Kong's ability to trade as an independent financial centre. So, who knows, but I think it's a good thing.
What are you going to do then, if now that this bill is signed into law? Is there anything that people like you can do to help Hong Kong stay, you know, the kind of special advantages in terms of trade and financial transactions?
Well, I think Hong Kong people have always adapted, so one will hope that they will work out a way to adapt to these problems like they've adapted to other changes in the past. But I think that no one knows what the effect will be yet, so we have to wait and see.
Yeah. What do you think this bill will do to the social polarization of Hong Kong? I mean, we just had this district election.
It's definitely not going to help. I think Hong Kong needs to heal. I think both sides need to listen to each other and learn from what's happened. Mm-hmm. I think there's been a problem with perception bias in Hong Kong, in that the protesters don't understand what the people who disagree with them feel, and those people who disagree with the protest don't understand where the protest is coming from and why they feel so strongly about the things that they're protesting about. So I think there's been a big disconnect in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
And both sides need to listen to the other side, otherwise we're never going to heal.
Yeah, and with this bill, does it make it better, easier for them to listen to each other?
Of course not. I don't think so. I don't see how this helps one little bit.
Mm. What about the trade war? I mean, the trade frictions, let's say, between China.
Personally, I see this as part of the trade war. I think that the protesters have got their concerns, but I think that that has been fueled and paid for by American money. And so I think this is part of the trade war, in a certain sense. I really believe America must have some role in funding this.